Here we'll talk about the RMS calculation based on the Fourier series expansion components. Here we have the general form for the Fourier series expansion, and f of t is our periodic waveform. We have a0, our DC term, and then we have c1 and our sine term. This is the fundamental term based on n equals 1, and then we have up to infinity, n equals 2, n equals 3, to infinity. These are our higher order harmonic terms. We're going to apply this to current and voltage. So we're going to start with current. Our current waveform can be rewritten in the same form. So I of t is our periodic current waveform, and we have a DC term. This is the same as the RMS value of the DC of the waveform, so we call that I0. And we're going to rewrite each of these coefficients a little bit differently. So C1 will become square root of 2 times the RMS value of the fundamental component. So that's I1. And then the same pattern for all the higher coefficients. It's going to be square root of 2 times the RMS value of the n equals 2 term for the waveform. So that continues all the way up to infinity. We're now going to look at what Valerie wants us to solve for, the RMS value for the current. So we start with the basics, just following the equation. 1 over t, integral of t, sorry, from 0 to t. Then we just take this guy, put it into here, and solve. Easy, right? Well, we'll see. This is an infinite series, and we're trying to square it. This is not an easy task, but let's look at some patterns here. Let's first take this I0, and we're going to multiply that by the series. So I0 would be the first term. We multiply that first by itself. We would get I0 squared. And then we would multiply that by the next term. But remember that we're taking an average. Whenever you multiply by a sign and you take an average of a sign, the average of a sign is always 0. So all of those terms will go to 0 once we take the average. So instead of writing that out, I'm going to do non-mathematical terms here. We're just going to call this others. So these are the other terms multiplied by I0. Then we would go to the next term. So now we would take this term and we're going to multiply it by each of the terms in the expansion. So again, this times IO, you're going to get a sine and you're going to take the average of that. That's also going to be 0. So we'll count that as others. Then we need to take this term, multiply it by itself. Here we will actually get something out. So I'm just going to write the format here. So squared, we would get 2, and then I1 squared. And I'm going to write it as an I squared, or a sine squared, omega t plus phi 1. Let's leave that as it is for now. Let's then multiply this one. We're going to go multiply these by all the higher order harmonics. We have sine multiplied by sine, but you'll notice the frequency here, they're different. When you have two terms that have different frequencies, the average of them is going to be 0. So we can count these again as others that we know are going to go to 0. And then we can go to the next term. I'm going to write it here. And we can do the same thing. This would be multiplied by this again. That's going to be 0 because of the sign. It's going to multiply by this. Because the frequencies are different, they're going to cancel out. Then we would multiply it by itself. And we would get this general term 2i2 squared and sine squared of omega, 2 omega t plus phi 2. And again, as we multiply by the other ones, they are going to be different frequencies, so they are going to become 0 once we take the average. So I'm going to put that as others. And it continues on in this fashion. And close the integral. The important terms here are going to be these ones, which are each of the terms multiplied by themselves. And all the other ones are going to cancel out to 0 once we evaluate the mean. I'm not going to go through all the math here, but if you use a trig identity, you can solve for each of these equations, the sine squared, and evaluate this expression. What you'll get at the end is actually something that's not that bad. So we have our I0 term here squared, and we get essentially the RMS value for each of the higher order components squared. So I0 squared plus I1 squared plus I2 squared plus 3, 4, 5, and so on. So for the RMS value, you can break it down into its individual components, and you'll see the overall RMS value for the full waveform is equivalent to the square root of the sum of squares for each of the components, including the DC value, fundamental, and the higher order harmonics. For completeness, let's also write the voltage here, and it's going to be the exact same format. The fundamental value, which is the same as the DC value, squared plus V1 squared plus V2 squared, and so on into infinity. So if we take a waveform and we write it in this form for the Fourier series expansion, we have the RMS values for each of the components, including the DC, fundamental, and the higher order harmonics. We can find the RMS value from each of these individual components, and we find that they have this relationship for each of the components relative to the overall RMS value for the waveform. So these are important equations to remember.